Now, in this video, we are going to be looking at distance and working out distance. Now, you'll probably in the question, it will say, how far or what distance did it travel? Okay. So when we're doing distance, it's always speed multiplied by time. So speed times time will give me the distance. Let's have a practical example. A cyclist rides for 5 hours at a speed of 38 kilometers an hour. Highly unlikely looking at that, old chap. Start again. A cyclist rides for 5 hours at a speed of 38 kilometers an hour. So there, 5 hours. Okay, sorry, 5 hours. And a speed of 38 kilometers per hour. Multiply those two and you'll get your distance. The question says, how far does he cycle? How far does he cycle? Again, just recap. Speed equals 38 and the time was 5. Okay. So distance is equal to speed times time. So quite simply, 38 times 5 in 5 hours, he would have cycled 190 kilometers. Doubt it, but anyway, that's the example. Let's look at another one. An aeroplane flies at a speed of 474 kilometers an hour for 3 hours and 10 minutes. Ah, they've latched on 10 minutes now. Makes it a little bit more difficult. An aeroplane flies at a speed of 474 kilometers an hour for 3 hours and 10 minutes. Question, how far does it fly? Far, how far is distance? So again, speed is 474. Time is 3 hours and 10 minutes. Now look at the 1/6 there. 1/6. 10 minutes, think a little bit. How many minutes in an hour? 60. So what fraction is 10 minutes over 60? We simplify it and it's 1/6. So the full 3 hours and 1/6 equating to the 10 minutes. So how do we set the sum out? Again, distance will be equal to the speed times 3 1/6. We need to make this into a top-heavy fraction. So it is 474 over 1 times 19 over 6. Okay, no need to invert this one because it's not division, it's multiplication. We can do some cross dividing, or you take your calculator, because these sums are normally in your calculator papers, and you multiply 474 by 19, and the answer you get, you divide by 6. And the answer is 1,501 kilometers.